Hi friends, welcome to Education for You channel. Today I will be discussing about generations of operating system. As we know, operating system is the heart of any computing system. Okay, it is basically a collection of programs which acts as interface between the user and the computer's hardware. Okay, so let us see how the operating systems have evolved over a period of time. So, operating systems have been evolving over the years. Initially, operating systems concept was not there. Okay. Then eventually, the programmers and developers felt the need of operating systems. Operating systems gave the much required control over the entire computing resources. That's why computers began to adopt operating systems into their system. So, as you can see, computer operating systems can be divided into four generations, starting from rather than five generations. Starting from 0th generation to 4th generation. Okay, let us see various generations and operating system characteristics of various generations now. Coming to 0th generation, it refers to the period of development of computing. The development of computing was very nascent at this stage. Okay, it dates back to invention of analytical engine by Charles Babbage, then computers by John Atanasoff in 1940. Similarly, in 1944 at Harvard University, Mark I developed by Howard Aiken. Okay, then came ENIAC, EDVAC, so on. Okay, so EDVAC set the stage for evolution of commercial computing and operating system software. But still, actual operation took place without benefit of operating system during the entire 0th generation. Programs were written in machine language only. And the operation was called as open shop operation, where users signed up for computer time. Then particular time was assigned to the user. Okay, on that time programmer or the user was responsible for machine setup, operation and subsequent cleanup. Then after the cleanup, the machine was offered to another user. This system was very inefficient and dependent on programmers competency, because if a programmer was not competent enough to do the cleanup properly, then the next user was facing problems. Okay, now let's see first generation. First generation was the period from 1951 to 1956. It marked the beginning of commercial computing. Vacuum tubes were introduced in the computers. Okay. It was the mode of operation in which first generation computers worked is known as closed shop mode. In the closed shop mode, there were hired operators who would select jobs to run, and then they make the system ready and they themselves execute the job, and then they will move on to another job. So in this one, it was very convenient for the users to submit a job, because they will not be bothered about the cleaning up and presenting the job to another person. Then application programs were run one at a time. This is a major disadvantage of first generation. Monoprogrammed operating systems were developed. It consisted of kernel in main storage, job scheduler, and number of utility programs kept in secondary storage. So, always a kernel was present in the main storage. Okay. Then came assembly language and Fortran etc. languages were developed during this period of time. Major disadvantage of this generation computers was CPU waited relatively longer times. Okay. Because there were mechanical input output devices for reading and writing the program data. That's why waiting time of CPU was very high. Also, there was a problem of system protection. There was no security at all. Now let's see second generation. Second generation began from 1956 and continued till 1964. In this generation, vacuum tubes were replaced by transistors. Monoprogrammed batch processing operating systems were developed. Okay. Data channels were introduced through which CPU waiting time reduced considerably. Data channels were used to read and write the data concurrently. Okay. Thus, CPU waiting time was reduced. CPU continued to be underutilized as sequential processing with one job at a time was being done. So, as the operating system was being made to execute one by one, the CPU continued to be underutilized. Now coming to third generation. Third generation was the period from 1964 to 1979. In this generation, integrated circuits, that is ICs, which integrated hundreds of transistors, were introduced. Because of their volume of transistors, the computers became more speedy and also economical. And multi-programming was adopted across the computing world. Two new systems programs introduced, that is one system reader which will move input jobs from card to disk, and second one is system writer that will move the job output from disk to any output, that is printer or tape or card. Concept of operating system became major element of computing in this generation. Now coming to fourth generation, which started in 1979, and still we are in the fourth generation of computing. So in the fourth generation, personal computers and workstations were manufactured and sold. The computers were very miniaturized because of VLSI technology, that is very large scale integration, which consisted of thousands of transistors in a small chip. We call it ICs today itself. Size of computer reduced significantly in this generation. Also, computers have become very inexpensive and also user friendly. Support for multi-programming and time sharing was enabled in this generation. Also, networking has evolved. Similarly, distributed systems operating systems were developed so that multiple computers are made to look like as a single computer system for the end user. So these were the four generations rather than five generations of computers operating system. So thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe if you like our channel, and also don't forget to hit the like button. Thank you.